Premier Auto 060, y como les prometimos, vamos, we're gonna switch back to English immediately because, as we said in the introduction of the show, we are talking to Ross Rader from the Institute of Insurance and Highway Safety. How are you, Ross?
Great, how are you doing today?
Thank you, very good, thank you. Thank you for taking the time talking to us, and you have pretty good and cool news from the IIHS, right? For a lot of people now, that you entered the YouTube era now.
Well, people are always asking us about how we do our crash tests and what it looks like behind the scenes in setting up and conducting our tests with crash test dummies and all the things that go into it. And so we wanted to give people an opportunity to see that through our YouTube channel, and we've launched an 8-part series that allows people to pull the curtain back and see how our engineers do their work at our test facility in Rutgersville, Virginia.
Yeah, it's very interesting. I'm part of the media who covers the auto industry, and obviously I have a little bit more access than the general public, but this is amazing that you're doing this, because it's very important information for people when they're deciding. We'll just talk about the top 10 list of our best SUVs under $25,000, which was compiled by the Kelley Blue Book. And this is like another aspect of the information that most people, some people don't even think about, and now they have this this valuable asset for them to take a decision, right?
Yeah, and I think we know people are using our crash test ratings when they are shopping for a new vehicle, and seeing how all of the research that goes into those crash tests, I think, gives people an idea of how important the ratings are in determining the safety of the vehicle that you want to buy.
Yeah, I'm looking at the YouTube channel, which, by the way, you just go to YouTube and you type IIHS and you'll find it. You Google it and it will come up immediately. It's pretty cool. Pretty cool design. I was looking at one of the Subaru Forester, and you already have 80,000 views already, and it was posted like a week ago. So it's getting a lot of traffic, huh?
Generating a lot of traffic, and it, you know, we've had our website for a long time to allow people to look up crash test ratings. Now with the YouTube channel, they can actually see the crash tests as they were done, and see how the vehicles, what the performance of the vehicle is visually behind those ratings. And we just released a group of tests of small SUVs. This is a group of SUVs that have undergone our new small overlap test for the first time. This is a crash in which only the front corner of the vehicle is involved in the crash. And it's a challenging test for vehicles to get through. And the Subaru Forester was one of the standouts in that test.
Yeah. Can you explain a little bit about why this test is important, more important, well, I don't know, more important or less important. It's important than the previous one that you were doing, please?
Well, the Institute has done front, side, rear, and rollover tests. But we continually look through the research at other areas that we should be examining, and in doing that research, we saw that there was this gap in frontal crash tests in which about a quarter of the serious injuries and deaths that occur in frontal crashes are happening in this small overlap configuration, mm-hmm. where only the front 20% or so of the front end of the vehicle hits another car or a tree or a pole. And so we developed this test to mimic that kind of crash scenario, and what we're finding is that most vehicles don't do a good job in protecting people in those kinds of crashes, and we want this test to drive improvement to fill in this gap in crash safety.
Yeah. And which of the vehicles that the recent small agencies besides the Forester has come up with good ratings or water ratings for the test that you have recently done?
Well, in this new tougher test, the Subaru Forester was the first vehicle to ace every aspect of the small overlap test, doing well across the board with no demerits, earned a good rating overall, one of the few vehicles to do that. The Mitsubishi Outlander Sport earned an acceptable rating in the small overlap test. So both these vehicles are designated as what we call Top Safety Pick Plus. meaning they do well in the Institute's regular crash tests, and now they're earning good or acceptable ratings in this tougher small overlap test. A lot of vehicles, a number of vehicles did poorly or earned marginal ratings in the test. The BMW X1, the Honda CR-V, the Mazda CX-5, and the Volkswagen Tiguan, as well as the Nissan Rogue and the Jeep Wrangler two-door, earned marginal ratings, and another five vehicles are rated poor.
Yeah, and then the list is very important because obviously I'm watching the videos actually without sound, obviously, but it's pretty impressive. What's the speed of the test? About 40 miles an hour, I believe?
Yes, it's 40 miles per hour, and the vehicle comes down a 600-foot runway and crashes into a rigid barrier that's meant to represent the front end of another car or a tree or a pole, some sort of narrow object. And the vehicle hits that barrier with just a 20% overlap, which means that it's basically just at the left headlight. And that typically misses the main crash-absorbing structures that are centered in the front end of the vehicle.
Yeah, it's pretty dramatic because not only the impact of the car against the barrier, but also when you go, the video goes in slow motion and you see the action of the airbags. In some of the cars, the dummy goes sideways from the airbag, which obviously probably protects a little bit, but not as much as the other ones, right? So it takes every aspect of the safety systems in the car.
Yeah, you want the structure of the vehicle to hold up well. Because if it doesn't, then it's more likely that the steering wheel is going to move away from the driver, and that takes the frontal airbag with it. So what we're seeing in a lot of the poor performers is that if that structure collapses and the steering wheel moves, the driver's head wants to move to the left,
yeah,
while the steering wheel wants to move to the right. And you get that gap between the frontal airbag and the side curtain airbag, and it's more likely the driver's head is going to hit something hard, which you don't want, obviously.
Yeah, absolutely. And also, I mean, not only the airbag that comes out from the wheel, but also I'm seeing in the video that some of the new SUVs, even the compact ones, have the knee airbag, which is also very, very important, right?
We don't know whether the knee airbag adds a lot to protection yet, but certainly the front airbag and the side curtain airbag need to work together to protect the upper body. And that is a key part of this, because if the driver comes in contact with the hard parts of the interior or hard structures that are coming in to the vehicle in the crash, then it's much more likely that they'll sustain serious injuries.
Yeah. We're talking to Russ Rader from the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety. And Russ, the website is IIHS.org. That's correct, right?
Yep. And you can see all of the ratings that we've done there, and including these new small SUV tests.
Yeah. And let me ask you, I'm watching the videos, and I'm seeing, like, to prepare the test, it has to be very, very precise, because you don't want to miss. I mean, you're destroying the car, but you wanted to do it in the right way, right?
it's an interesting process. It actually takes 2 days to prepare a vehicle for a test like this, starting with draining the flammable fluid, like the gasoline, out of the vehicle,
uh-huh,
putting all the instrumentation in, and getting the dummy ready. It's a long process.
Yeah, and you get one shot, right? You don't want to spend another, whatever, $25,000 every time you do it.
You got to do a lot of the preparation to make sure you get it right, because it's a very expensive mistake if you don't get it right.
Yeah, but very valuable information for the public, and now that it's on YouTube, I think it's even more, it takes another level of relevance for people who have access to this. And just like, as I was seeing the video while we were talking, just the images are so powerful that it really conveys a very powerful message for the public.
Yeah, we hope that it gives people a better sense of how important safety ratings are and the crash testing that's done.
Yeah. Well, thank you very much for your time, Russ. Always a pleasure to talk to you. Very important information from the Institute, Insurance Institute for Highway Safety. So I hope to talk to you soon again, and maybe one day we'll visit the lab there and see something of this live.
Yeah, you're welcome anytime. Happy to do it.
Thank you very much, Russ. Pues ahí tiene la información sobre el Instituto de Aseguradoras y Seguridad en las Carreteras, demostrando cómo es que hacen las pruebas de los choques que en el pasado eran un poco, no secretas, pero no teníamos tanto acceso como tenemos ahora a través del canal de YouTube. Pueden ahora, no voy a decir disfrutar, pero pueden mirar los videos y darse cuenta en realidad de lo importante que son todos los sistemas de seguridad en los autos. Y cómo en realidad un impacto a 40 millas por hora, que en realidad no pareciera ser una velocidad tan elevada, puede causar tanto daño en la cabina, y sobre todo con esta nueva prueba que están haciendo de un lado del auto, el 20% del lado frontal izquierdo del auto, cómo puede impactar eso en los resultados, que en algunos casos pueden ser fatales. Así que los dos modelos que salieron mejor en esta prueba por ahora son la Forester, Subaru Forester 2014, y la Mitsubishi Outlander también del 2014. Vamos a colocar también obviamente el link al video para que en nuestro canal de Facebook, perdón, al canal de YouTube del Instituto, para que puedan ver esos videos.